So here I am walking along a road on the approach to Pendeen. I don't know, I think we're about 65 miles. Anyway, the wheels have come off and the left knee is not playing ball, which means I've got a 37 mile death march to the finish left, which I'm not wildly excited about. This is the start of the arc of Attrition 100. I'm in Cornwall. It's a good crowd gathered. It's 100 miles around the coastal path from about 10 miles east of Lizard Point all the way around to about 20 miles east of St Ives in an arc. See what they did there. If you consult your calendars, you'll notice that it's January, which means weather's a factor. I'm quite excited. We'll see if I still am at 2 in the morning, staggering around somewhere around Land's End. Lovely. Conditions are great. Yeah. Start really.
There's a boy with his head pressed up to the window. The bus headed out of town.
Hey, can we found? Chloe. Say hi.
Hi.
Say hi, Chloe.
Yeah.
We're at Lizard Point, which is behind us. Is that a pancake? It's a tasty pancake. Are you carb loading as well? It's all going fine so far, lovely day. Just look at that. Stunning. Best real view since turning around Lizard. Tonight's the kind of night where everything could change. Tonight's the kind of night. Oh, this is lovely. There are 20 miles in the bank. 4 hours 20 in. Just gone through the very pretty Gunwalla Cove, I think it's called. I mean, look at that. Fabulous. So it's about 5 miles to go till the first checkpoint, quarter way point, by which point it'll be dark and head torch on, and then just 14 hours of darkness to pack through and count down waiting for the dawn to come. This is Penzance, or 2 miles out from 38 miles in about 8.5 hours. Pretty happy with how it's gone so far. Just on a bit of a downward lull, but there's another checkpoint up in a couple of miles. So get another refuel. Still get Chloe again, but they've gone off to bed now. So out here on my own until the morning. The Minak steps. For my watch, I've got about 52 miles. I think there are 50 to go because the 50 starts from here at 8 o'clock in the morning. It's about 12:15, I think. So I'm pretty happy with how the first half has gone. So up next is 5 hopefully relatively easy miles through to Land's End, and then the nub of the race really, 23 miles from there to St Ives, which is like the gnarliest bit. According to the race plan, it will take 8 hours to do those 23 miles. But anyway, I'm about on track for 28 hours at the moment, which is good. So this is the aid station at St Ives. Just stuffing my face with a plate of meatballs, a plate of veggie chilli, a cup of tea. It's not going as well as it was at the start of that, or I don't know, 5 miles ago. Got some knee trouble. Someone's going to tape it up in a minute, otherwise it's paracetamol. And hope for the best. not massively looking forward to the next 23 miles, which is the make or break section to St Ives. Well, these weather's alright, it's going to get a bit colder, but it's not wet. Brown's great. Can't ask too much more than that. So I was happy, and now I'm unhappy. A bit unhappy. And I'm hoping that the knee can be salvaged a bit, otherwise it's a very long walk. 45 miles to go to the finish. Right, it's daylight. And that concludes the good news. It's not been a very good few hours. Knees knackered, ankles now knackered. Can't really run. I'm cold. I'm just trying to survive until the next checkpoint, which is about 8 miles. That's St Ives, it is. Yeah, it's 10 to 8. We've got 71 miles done. The race is a bit longer than 100, so about 30 left. It's going to take a long time. Alright, so just leaving St Ives. There are 80 miles in the books. I've been going for 24 and a half hours. Pace is horrible. My knee and ankle are now held together by tape. I've got an arduous 7 or 8 or 9 hour walk into the finish ahead. Asking myself such questions as, why am I bothering? What a disaster. Disastrous second half of the race. And just got to finish now, try and salvage anything from it. That's not what I had in mind for the day. There we go. 20 long, slow, tedious miles to go. All right, I'm back in the game. I'm in the sand dunes, or the dunes of doom, as they are known in the race, although not that doomy. Pretty easy to follow the markings. And I got the map on my watch. So I had a really good last 10 miles since St Ives. Got my mojo back. I've been able to run. So it looks like the tape and strapping on my knee and ankle have been effective. So yeah, it's nice to finish, or to head towards the finish, with a bit of spring in my step rather than the horrible trudge that I was doing before that on the way into St Ives. Stinging the tail up ahead. Big descent, not great for my legs. Big climb, not great for my legs. It's 5:15, which means I'm up to 29 and a quarter hours. And there are 5 miles to go. This is the cliffs above Portreath. All very dramatic. I haven't really paid too much attention to the scenery, if I'm honest. I've certainly been aware of the sound of the sea, particularly during the night, as an ever-present, but kind of my mind and other things in terms of looking at it. Although I did see some seals back there and some dolphins in the bay near St Ives, and a mouse near Mousehole. So, you know, it's been a success in terms of wildlife spotting. The last time I checked in, I was on the high of the roller coaster, and now I'm very much back in the trough, or whatever it's called, the bit at the bottom. And just sort of solemnly ambling my way towards the finish line. I think so. So here I am in Portown. 101 and a bit miles in the book, and it's just a small matter of the 3/4 mile drag uphill to the finish line to go. It's a particularly painful descent off that last headland. Right ankle is in bits, despite being held together brilliantly by strapping for the last 25 miles or whatever. Left knee seems okay, but we haven't done any running for a while, so maybe that's why. Just trying to like think back on what's happened. Started all right, first half, the most part went pretty well, and then absolutely fell apart in the third quarter, the most difficult part of the race. Had some knee trouble, was too impatient to get sorted out at Land's End. Absolute error. What an idiot. Suffered with that, which turned into ankle trouble, which itself stemmed from impatience at the start, trying to overtake people. Went over on my ankle like mile 3. So, a little learning lesson there. You can run 99 miles on a sprained ankle, apparently. And then, I messed up the nutrition and food and stuff. So I had these like wild waves of highs and feeling great and going quickly, and then like absolutely bonking and crashing and burning. Gathered it up a bit towards the end. I think I'll be rushing back to a winter ultra. That is the arc of attrition. Not doing that again. Right, so that's that. 102 miles in the end, 31 hours, 11 minutes. Not what I was planning or expecting at the start of yesterday. As I said, all sorts of things went wrong and I made loads of mistakes. But pretty pleased to have got over the line despite all that, because I could have bailed it. Land's End, there was definitely an option. Kit was there with the car, it would have been easy. So I'm glad I stuck with it, and any 100 completion is you get no easy ones, so it's good to earn the buckle and stick it on the downstairs loo Hall of Fame with the others.